the dinosaur's lungs.
George's favourite toy is Mr. Dinosaur.
Dinosaur.
George loves Mr. Dinosaur. Sometimes George likes to scare Peppa with Mr. Dinosaur. At supper time, Mr. Dinosaur sits next to George.
I beg your pardon. Was that you, George? Or was it Mr. Dinosaur?
Dinosaur.
Good night, Peppa.
Good night, Mummy.
Good night, George. And good night, Mr. Dinosaur.
When George goes to bed, Mr. Dinosaur is tucked up with him. George's favourite game is throwing Mr. Dinosaur up in the air and catching him when he falls back down. Peppa and Daddy Pig are playing draughts.
What?
I win, Daddy!
George?
George, what's the matter?
I'm sore.
George has lost Mr. Dinosaur.
Don't worry, George. We'll find Mr. Dinosaur.
It's a job for a detective.
Daddy, what is a detective?
A detective? A detective?
I'm good at finding things.
Are you sure about that?
All right. Peppa is the detective.
George? I'm the detective. I will help you find Mr. Dinosaur.
Maybe the detective should ask George some simple questions.
George, where's Mr. Dinosaur?
If I knew where he was, we wouldn't be here right now.
The detective could try and guess where Mr. Dinosaur might be.
I know where he is.
Are you sure about that?
Unrelated to the topic, but when I reused the same clip from earlier in the video, I realized that the lamp no clipped into the back rooms.
George always has Mr. Dinosaur with him in the bath. So Mr. Dinosaur is in the bath.
Mr. Dinosaur is not in the bath.
I know where Mr. Dinosaur is. George always has Mr. Dinosaur in his bed at night. See, that's where he is.
Mr. Dinosaur is not in George's bed.
Maybe we should try the garden.
Yes, the garden! I was going to say that.
Are you sure about that?
Mr. Dinosaur.
Mr. Dinosaur is very hard to find.
George?
That is mean, but okay.
You do love to throw Mr. Dinosaur in the air. I wonder if this time you threw Mr. Dinosaur just a bit too high.
Help me! Help me!
I'm sore.
Maybe it isn't a good idea to play with dinosaurs near trees.
time. You didn't have to cut me off. Like now we were nothing. Peppa is going to a sleepover at Zoe Zebra's house.
Hello, Zoe.
Hi, Peppa. Welcome.
Wait, guys, where's pizza?
I'll pick you up in the morning. Bye-bye, Peppa.
Bye.
Rebecca, Susie and Emily are already here. You didn't have to cut me off.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, Peppa.
I've got my teddy.
Zoe has her toy monkey.
Monkey.
Emily has her frog. Susie has her owl. And Rebecca has her carrot.
Carrot, carrot.
Mr. Zeb.
Oh my god!
That's better.
I was watching that.
But it was a bit boring, Daddy.
Daddy Zebra is going to bed now. He has to get up early to deliver the post. Stay up too late.
Good night, Mummy.
Peppa and her friends are getting into their sleeping bag. Zoe's baby twin sisters, Zuzu and Zaza, want to join the sleepover too.
The sleepover is only for big girls.
Can they stay?
Okay, but you must promise you'll stay awake.
We promise.
Wow, a piano. I'm having lessons. Listen.
You emotional. Can I go get a glass of water?
Shush! You must be quiet so Daddy Zebra can sleep. Now, into your sleeping bags, please.
What do we do now? On sleepovers, there's always sleepovers. On sleepovers, there's always a midnight feast. What's a midnight feast? We eat things. You didn't have to cut me off. I know where there's food, but we must be very quiet. Shh, Susie. Shh, Peppa.
Shut up!
We're going to have the best midnight feast ever.
What's going on? You'll wake Daddy Zebra. Now, who knows a nice, gentle bedtime story?
Me!
And me!
I'll start. Once upon a time, there was a little fairy. Now your turn, Peppa. And she lived in the midnight feast. She was very mid and she had a fairy.
Lovely.
Your turn, Emily. Tell us what happens next.
Well, I'm not really sure.
Just say anything, Emily.
Okay. The little fairy met a big monster who went...
Charlie's like a melody.
Too scary.
What's all this noise?
Oh. The noise has woken Mr. Zebra.
Sorry, Daddy. There's a story about a fairy and a scary monster. And we want to know what happens next.
Very well.
Whopper, 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 junior, double, triple, whopper, finger taste with perfect toppers, I rule this day, let us be.
And he said...
Mr. Zebra's song has sent everyone to sleep. Peppa's playgroup are going on a trip to the museum.
Oh dear! Pedro Pony is not here.
What? I bet he's still in his pajamas.
Pedro is asleep in his
pajamas.
Pedro likes sleeping.
Pedro! Wake up! You'll be late for the school trip.
Okay, Mummy.
Come on, Pedro. We don't want to miss the bus.
The bus is still waiting for Pedro Pony.
We can't wait any longer. The museum will be closed.
Let's go.
Oh, there's no one here.
You didn't have to cut me off.
Maybe we're early. No, Pedro. We've missed the bus.
You didn't have to cut me off.
Oh, come on. Let's catch them up.
Look, there's a car chasing us.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Pony.
Stop the bus! Pedro is here!
Sorry, Madame Gazelle. I overslept.
Oh, Pedro, you do like sleeping.
Yes, Madame Gazelle.
To the museum. Nothing can stop us now.
This is Grandad Dog's garage.
What will it be? Petrol or diesel?
Toilet, please.
Are you sure you wouldn't like any petrol?
No!
Right, next stop, the museum.
Where is Pedro?
早上好，中国。现在我有冰淇淋。
Come and get Pedro!
Bye!
I hope we get to the museum before it closes.
Here is the museum. Mr. Rabbit is locking up for the day.
Mr. Rabbit, we would like to see the museum, please.
We were just closing. But I can give you a quick tour. And through this door is the most amazing place of all. It's the fantastic world you live in. Goodbye.
Mr. Bombastic, Bomba Fantastic.
Right, time to go, children.
Where is Pedro?
Oh, Pedro! Come on, Pedro.
Where is everybody?
The bus has gone.
Don't worry. Miss Rabbit will realize she's left us behind.
Nobody has noticed Madame Gazelle and Pedro are missing.